Well, hello there, this is Chris from Rekombu, and I'm here with the fresh new OnePlus 5T handset, just launched here at the end of 2017, just sneaking in there. And we're here with the Google Pixel 2 XL as well, launched just a month prior by good old Google, rocking some very premium specs, but also a much higher price tag. So this bad boy here cost from £799 in the UK, whereas the OnePlus 5T starts at just £449, so almost half the price. So is the Pixel really worth that extra money? Well, let's take a look. So first of all, in terms of the general design, as you can see, there's not much difference in terms of the dimensions, or in fact, the overall general look of the two handsets from the front. Obviously, they both sport an 18:9 aspect ratio, so a nice stretch screen with tiny little bezels above and below the display. So definitely got a nice cinematic feel to them. Very good if you watch a bit of Netflix on the go, things like that. You get very little letterboxing. You of course do get these nice sort of like curved corners to the Google Pixel 2 XL, whereas it's a much more straight-laced rectangular screen on the OnePlus 5T, both very good-looking handsets. We flick around. As you can see, they're reasonably slender as well, considering the size of these bad boys. You do get a ever so slightly adjusting camera lens, but there's really not much in it, to be honest. We flip around to the back, you'll see the design isn't massively different in this case. You do get a nice metallic finish stretching top to bottom on the OnePlus 5T, whereas you get this nice little sort of glossy panel up top on the Google Pixel 2 XL. Helps to break up the general design and just adds a nice little sort of extra effect to it. It does smudge up quite badly though, so you want to keep that buffed up whenever possible. As you see, it's a reasonably plain design in both cases as well, just a little bit of branding. And in both cases, you get a rear-mounted fingerprint sensor. It's all centrally positioned as well, and it's nice and nippy. So just a quick tap, boop, and you're straight into your handset. Both are pretty rugged devices as well. You can give them a good knocking around and they're generally all right. It's got a couple of tiny little light scratches on the OnePlus so far. The Google Pixel certainly seems to put up with all kinds of punishment, no problem. And the Pixel actually has the benefit of being water resistant as well. It's IP67 rated. So you can give it a good old dunking in the bath, take it in the shower, do what you like with it. As well as those fingerprint sensors, the OnePlus 5T also sports a Face ID facial recognition feature. So instead of using the sensor, all you do is you just put your face close to it, turn the phone on, and it just goes straight into the desktop. So it bypasses lock screen instantly, which is pretty handy. So it's an alternative. It's no quicker, of course, than using the fingerprint sensor, but it will be better if you're, for instance, using gloves or your hands are a bit mucky from cooking, cleaning, doing whatever. So it's good as a little alternative. In terms of general one-handed use, of course, they're both pretty big handsets, but they do help out a bit. For instance, the OnePlus, you can pull down the notifications bar from wherever on the screen, nice and simple, just like that. And in the case of the Pixel phone, you can actually set it up so you can use the fingerprint sensor to pull down the notifications bar like so. So that's nice and handy too. As for the screens, it's a nice 6-inch spacious screen in both cases. It's an OLED in both cases as well. It's a P-OLED on the Pixel and an AMOLED in the case of the OnePlus. Nice punchy visuals on the OnePlus. They seem a little bit more muted, unfortunately, on the Pixel. Not quite as vibrant, not quite as sexy. But they're both nice bright panels and sort of decent viewing angles as well on the OnePlus 5T. No kind of image fade or anything. Unfortunately, in the case of the Pixel, it does have a bit of a bluey tint to it when you start to tilt it away from your face, which is kind of distracting, but it's nothing major, you know. You get used to it pretty quick, actually. And it's still a very, very nice screen indeed, as I say, with that 18:9 aspect ratio, nice and cinematic. And the Pixel does have the advantage that it is actually a sharper screen as well. It's a 2880 by 1440 Quad HD resolution, whereas the OnePlus sticks with good old Full HD. But in this case, of course, it's 2160 by 1080 because of that stretched aspect ratio. In both cases, though, you're going to get nice crisp images. As you can see, you'll struggle to make out any individual pixels on either of these handsets. So they definitely do the job for your HD movies, browsing photos, all that kind of stuff. In the case of the Pixel, of course, it's not a surprise to discover that it is, of course, running full Android Oreo, the latest version of Android OS, with, of course, all the bonuses and benefits that brings, which in the case of right now isn't actually that much. Actually, you've got like some picture-in-picture mode, which doesn't work on most apps, which is a bit of a shame. and not a massive difference in terms of the general resource management and all of that that we've discovered. In the case of course, the OnePlus, you are just running Android Nougat at the moment. It should be getting a full update to Oreo come the new year, 2018. And of course, you get Oxygen OS on top of that, so that adds a few bonus features such as the nifty shelf, which we prefer to like the Google Now stuff. You get a little bit more customization as well. If you dive into the settings, you can customize exactly the exact grid layout and all that kind of stuff. And you get some bonus gesture support and things like that as well. So we've, of course, covered this all in full. Go check out or OnePlus 5T unboxing and hands-on if you want to see some more of that. As you can see, lots of gesture support, and if you dive into the advanced, you also get like a game and do not disturb mode and little bits like that. So some nice extra features that you don't find on the Pixel, of course, going along with that Face ID feature. That said, of course, the Pixel will get an update to full the next version of Android, so Android P, whatever that will be. They'll get that in a much more timely fashion, along with full beta support as well, which you won't get on the OnePlus 5T. And in terms of performance, of course, no complaints whatsoever from either of these handsets. They're both running Qualcomm's latest Snapdragon 835 chipset. In the case of the OnePlus 5T, it's backed by either 6 or 8 gigs of RAM, which is very, very generous indeed. In the case of the Pixel, it's 4 gigs. Not as generous, but still does the job no problem whatsoever. You see apps load up instantly, you can whiz around in the software, no problem, no delays or anything. It's nice and nippy. And exactly the same on the 5T, we'll be surprised to see any kind of slowdown anytime soon. You can play the latest games without issue. As for the storage space, you get 64 or 128 gigs of storage on both of these handsets. And sadly, that's not expandable via micro SD. But as you see, it gives you tons of space. If you get the 128 gig model, which costs $499 on the OnePlus 5T, you'll struggle to fill that up. Of course, the Pixel also comes with the added benefit of the fact that you get unlimited Google Photos storage, so you can store all of your photos and videos at the full resolution, no problem whatsoever. So at least you can delete them locally if you need to. And as for the battery tech, it's a 3,300 milliamp on the OnePlus. So far seems to give just over a day of pretty heavy use per charge. On the Pixel 2 XL, however, it's a slightly bigger 3,520 milliamp. And we found that really did the job. You can get at least a day and a half of use out of it, no problem at all. Close to 2 days if you're a little bit more restrained. So you'll definitely not struggle to get some decent life out of both of them. And they've both got a basic Android battery saver mode as well when needed. As for the quick charge as well, you get quick charge support on the Pixel phone, thanks to good old Qualcomm's quick charge 3.0, whereas you get OnePlus's dash charge feature on the OnePlus 5T. In both cases, you'll be able to power it up pretty heavily in just an hour at the plug, and also get a good solid couple of hours of use of it from just 10 or 15 minutes, so definitely does the job. As for your audio, well, of course, both support a bit of Bluetooth 5 and all of that, but unfortunately, you don't get any kind of headphone jack on the Pixel phone, completely bare as you can see. However, you do get dual stereo speakers on the front, which pump out some pretty impressive sound when needed. OnePlus 5T has a rear mounted speaker, not quite as powerful, sadly, but you do get a 3.5mm headphone jack, which is definitely good. Which brings us on to the camera tech. And as you can see, of course, if you flip both phones around, it's very different. You get a single lens camera on the rear of the Pixel 2 XL, whereas it's a dual lens snapper on the back of the OnePlus 5T. And the actual camera experiences are sort of reasonably different as well. As you can see, the interface isn't massively different from a quick glance, just a quick tap of the shutter button, and it takes a quick snap. Pretty nippy in both cases as well. And of course, you've got all these toggles down the left-hand side. You've got a bit of HDR mode and choose the aspect ratio, flash feature, and all that kind of stuff on the OnePlus. You get some bonus stuff, however, on the Pixel phone, such as, for instance, you can switch on motion, which basically shoots a quick video snippet every time you take a photo, and that just brings your gallery to life when you're flicking through all your photos. You can also, if you tap here, as you can see, you can have a quick fiddle around with the white balance and all that kind of stuff. However, the OnePlus 5T does have the benefit, if you pull out, you've got a full Pro mode, where you can fiddle around with white balances, also the rise of ISO levels and the shutter. So you've got more manual controls on the OnePlus 5T. You also get various other camera modes. So as you can see, you've got standard video mode, but you can also shoot slow motion and time lapse. And you also get a portrait mode, which uses both of those lenses in order to shoot a nice bit of bokeh effect, get a proper depth of field around your subject and help them to really stand out. If we tap down here on the Pixel, it'll load up their camera modes. And as you can see, it's a little bit more basic. You don't get the full pro mode. And also you don't get a time-lapse mode, but you do still get slow motion. And it does actually have that portrait mode in there, despite having just a single lens, which actually works surprisingly well. It still captures a good bit of bokeh, despite having that disability of only the one lens, which is quite impressive. Both phones can also shoot up to 4K resolution video. So as you can see, we just swap between there at 30 frames per second on both cases, and pretty good video stabilization on both as well. Definitely no problems there. And as for those front-facing cameras, you get an 8-megapixel lens on the Pixel 2 XL, whereas it's a 16-megapixel on the OnePlus. It's an f2.0 on the OnePlus, f2.4 on the Pixel, so slightly better in lower light in the case of the OnePlus, although there's not really much in it. Both phones will definitely do the job if you want your everyday shots, you want to take some home movies, things like that, so no worries there. And that, in a nutshell, is the Pixel 2 XL versus the OnePlus 5T. Both very, very solid premium handsets. Of course, a clear price difference between the two, and both phones have their own advantages as well. You get the likes of the Face ID on the OnePlus 5T and none of those strange POLED issues that you get on the Pixel. On the other hand, the Pixel phone is water resistant and it's got some extra benefits, such as the fact that it'll get the updates to the latest Android ahead of time, and the camera tech is still really, really, really good as well, and also better battery life. So which one do you think would float your boat? Let us know in the comments below. Thanks for watching, everyone, and cheers. Bye.